Hi, this is Anil from Learning Lad and welcome to another video tutorial on C programming language. Now in this video we will see how we can download and install the CodeBlocks IDE, and then we're gonna see how we can configure this CodeBlocks IDE along with the MinGW. So in the previous video we have seen how we can download and install the MinGW. Now here this CodeBlocks is one of the IDE which allows us to write and execute C programs. I chose this CodeBlocks IDE just because it is freely available and it is having less size, you know, below 100 MB, and also it is available for all the platforms, Windows, Mac and Linux. Now you can use any IDE available to you to write and execute the programs in C programming language. So now to download and install this CodeBlocks IDE, you need to open up any of the browser which you have. And once you open the browser, in the address bar, you need to type in codeblocks.org and then hit the enter button and it will open up the CodeBlocks website. And here you guys can see it says this is an open source cross-platform free C, C++ and Fortran IDE. And here we're just gonna see, you know, how we can install it. So we're gonna go to this download section, click on this downloads option, and we will be downloading and installing the binary release. So select this binary release, which means, you know, we are going to download the setup files. So just click on this. Now, as I said before, this CodeBlocks is available for all the three platforms. So you guys can select your platform and download. And here I'm going to be downloading this for the Windows operating system. Now with this CodeBlocks IDE, you have the option of installing this CodeBlocks IDE alone, or you can install the CodeBlocks IDE along with MinGW. Now in the previous video, I have downloaded and installed the MinGW, and that's why I'm not going to be doing that again. So I will just download and install this CodeBlocks IDE. Now, if you haven't installed the MinGW in your computer, then you can go for this CodeBlocks IDE along with the MinGW. You guys can see this here, CodeBlocks 16.01, which is the latest version available as of now, along with the MinGW setup.exe. You need to download this one if you haven't installed the MinGW already. Now, I have already installed the MinGW. And that's why I will go for this IDE only. So I will download this CodeBlocks 16.01 setup, and I will download it from SourceForge. So I'm gonna click on this SourceForge.net here, and it will take me to the SourceForge website and the download will start. Now I just have to wait for this download to finish. All right, now the download has been finished, and now let's open up the downloaded file. My downloaded file is stored in the downloads folder. So I'm gonna open up the downloads folder, and you guys can see the CodeBlocks setup.exe. Just double click on that to install it. And if it wants any permission, then give the permission. Let me just close this window here. Now here, click on this next, and you know, you can read all the license agreement, and after that click on I agree. Then select all these things and click on next. Then you know, the CodeBlocks will be installed in this location which is mentioned in here. That is the default location. If you want to change, you can change it, but I'm gonna keep it as it is. And then I'm gonna click on this install. Now it says, do you want to run CodeBlocks now? I will click on this yes. And then I'm gonna select this installation and click on next and click on this finish. Now the CodeBlocks will launch and it will detect the compiler that we have installed. So you guys can see it detects this GNU GCC compiler which we have installed in the previous tutorial. And also if you have installed this CodeBlocks along with the MinGW, then you will see this compiler here. You need to see that your compiler has been detected here. Once it has been detected, click on OK. And the CodeBlocks will launch, and it says, do you want to associate C and C++ source files with this CodeBlocks IDE? Now I just want to click on this no, leave everything as it is, and then click on OK. Now we have downloaded, installed and set up this CodeBlocks IDE along with the MinGW, which has installed the GNU GCC compiler. So let's just check out, you know, that everything has been set up properly. So for that purpose, click on this create new project, select console application and click on go, and then click on next and select C here, then click on next, then select the location where you want to save your project. So just gonna store that in my documents folder, and then I'm gonna click on OK. You can you know, make any folder in here, and then you need to give project your title. So I just wanna say test, and then I'm gonna click on next and select all these things as it displays, and then click on finish. Now here you guys can see management window. Just click on this plus sign and it will show this main.c. just double click on this file and it will open up here. Now you need to go to build and then build and run. Now if you see this window and if you see this hello world here, then it's gonna mean that you have set up everything properly and you can start writing the programs in C and C++ programming languages. So this is it guys, this is how you guys can download and install the CodeBlocks IDE and set it up with MinGW. And thank you for watching. If you think that this video will help any of your friends, then do share this video. And if you like this video, then give a thumbs up. And if you want to watch more tutorials, then subscribe to my channel. And once again, thank you and I'll see you in the next tutorial.